coming to you from Annapolis, Maryland, home of the U.S. Naval Academy, the sailing capital of the world, home of the world's largest crab feast, and four signers of the Declaration of Independence. This is the Eye on Annapolis Daily News Brief, a daily roundup of local news that you can use, including local sports, local events, local opinion, and local weather from DMV Weather. Now here's your host, publisher of Eye on Annapolis, John Frenay.
Good morning. It is Thursday, June 28th, 2018. This is John Frenay, and this is your Eye on Annapolis Daily News Brief. Welcome to the class of 2022. Yes, today is I Day or Induction Day at the United States Naval Academy, and Annapolis welcomes 1,000 new plebes for the start of plebe summer. Annapolis and Anne Arundel County Fire Departments and the Natural Resources Police have been busy. Yesterday, there were three separate water incidents. Early in the afternoon, with rough seas and heavy winds, a 911 call was received for a man overboard somewhere between Harrington Harbor South and Kent Narrows. Natural Resources Police spokesman Candy Thompson said that a man fell from a 40-foot cabin cruiser. The search for him was suspended about 9 p.m. last night and will be resumed again today. Shortly after that, Anne Arundel County Fire Department responded to Sandy Point State Park for a drowning incident. It turned out to be a near-drowning incident, and the 5-year-old boy was reportedly underwater for 4 to 5 minutes. Bystanders did perform CPR, and he was flown to the Johns Hopkins Children's Center in Baltimore in serious condition. Also about the same time, a windsurfer was rescued from the waters off Eastport by Natural Resources Police along with the U.S. Coast Guard. The single windsurfer had trouble riding his board in the wind and was not injured. Down in Prince George's County, a 6-year-old girl and a man are in the hospital from injuries they suffered from an electrical shock at the MGM National Harbor Tuesday night. It all happened at the outdoor fountain area on the west side of the building just before midnight. The girl was shocked, and an adult male employee of the casino stepped in to help and was shocked as well. The girl immediately went into cardiac arrest. She regained a pulse while en route to the hospital, where she remains in critical condition. The man who tried to help her is expected to be okay. MGM National Harbor is working and fully cooperating with Prince George's County Fire and EMS, as well as the police department. The area surrounding the fountain has been closed to the public while investigators are figuring out what happened. We all know the results of most of the races that happened in our primary on Tuesday. And the governor's race for November is off to a fast start. Governor Larry Hogan released 2 television commercials, and Ben Jealous is not too far behind. Jealous opened up his race against Hogan on the tax issue, accusing the governor of failing to follow through on a promise. It does prove to be a very interesting race, but Jealous has an awful lot of ground to make up. Currently, he has $260,000 in the bank compared to Governor Hogan's $8.2 million. I do imagine that Hogan will not spend $8.2 million in that campaign, and much of that money will go to down-ballot candidates that will be able to assist Hogan should he be successful again. Yesterday, huge news out of Washington, D.C. Supreme Court Justice Anthony Kennedy has announced that he will be retiring from the Supreme Court effective July 31st. In his letter to the president, Kennedy wrote, "My dear Mr. President, for a member of the legal profession, it is the highest honor to serve on this court. Please permit me by this letter to express my profound gratitude for having had the privilege to seek in each case how to best know, interpret, and defend the Constitution and the laws that must always conform to its mandates and promises." In response, Trump said that Kennedy had been a, quote, "great justice of the Supreme Court," and that efforts to replace him would begin immediately. Kennedy was appointed by President Reagan in 1988, and he has been the most critical swing member of the Supreme Court for more than a decade. Kennedy is 81 right now. This does set the scene for an epic battle between Congress and the White House. If you will remember, when Justice Alito passed away, Congress stonewalled any kind of appointment, claiming that they needed to wait until the new Congress was in session. It'll be interesting to see how they handle it this time, now that the shoe is on the other foot. Hey, that's about it for the top news. Make sure you're checking out ionanapolis.net for all of the other news throughout the day. We do update it consistently. And it is Thursday, so we have Trevor with your Annapolis Makers Minutes. And of course, like we do have every single day, we have George Young with your local DMV weather forecast coming right up.
Hi, this is Anne Arundel County Executive Steve Hsu. The heroin and opioid epidemic has touched every family, including mine. It breaks my heart to see families crippled by the trauma of addiction every single day. That's why we're doing everything possible to fight heroin and prescription drug abuse. If you're a parent, talk to your kids about the dangers of prescription drugs. Attend one of our Not My Child presentations in your neighborhood to learn the facts. We all think our children couldn't possibly be using heroin. Well, think again. If you're struggling with addiction yourself, now is the time to get help. Our Safe Stations program allows you to go to any fire station and ask for help. No questions asked, no one gets in trouble. Get educated and join us in the fight to save lives. Go to denialisdeadly.org or call 410-768-5522.
This is Maryland. The weather can be nearly unpredictable. We've got George Young from DMV Weather in Annapolis to sort it all out.
Hey everyone, this is George with DMV Weather, and this is your Eye on Annapolis forecast for Thursday, June 28th. After some possible early showers today, skies will clear and temps will jump up a bit into the mid to upper 80s for highs, and then Friday we'll see more sunshine and temperatures even a bit warmer in the upper 80s to near 90 degree range. Then once we get to the weekend, it'll be flat out a heat wave for Annapolis and all of Anne Arundel County, with temps in the 90s and humidity levels high enough that the heat index climbs to 100 plus degrees over the weekend with very little, if any, chances for rain as hot high pressure takes over the skies above. Okay, that's it for today. Be sure to follow DMV Weather anywhere, anytime on our website at dmvweather.com or on Facebook and Twitter, as well as on our app, which you can download for free by searching for DC MDVA Weather in the Apple App Store and Google Play Store. This is George Young of DMV Weather. Make it a great day out there today. And always remember, whatever the weather outside, have fun and be safe.
Do you know what your teens are doing this summer? Don't be afraid to ask. The most recent Maryland Safe and Supportive School survey shows 3/4 of Annapolis high school students say it was fairly or very easy for students in their grade to get alcohol. Underage and binge drinking is very real in Annapolis. If you give them access to alcohol, you're not cool, but you are liable for the outcome. Create a safe environment for your teens and their friends this summer. If they need to talk, listen. If you need to talk, we'll listen. We're here for you and your children. We're ASAP, Annapolis Substance Abuse Prevention. ASAP facilitates healthy community change, prevents and reduces binge drinking, underage drinking, and alcohol-related auto crashes among youth and young adults through locally led collaborations and evidence-based prevention strategies. Visit us at PreventSubstanceAbuse.org. This message is supported by SAMHSA and the Maryland Behavioral Health Administration.
This is Trevor from Annapolis Makerspace with this week's Maker Minutes. Saturdays through August, there's Learn to Kayak at Cherry Hill Splash Park in Brooklyn. Beginners are provided with kayaking instruction and skill building tips. Saturday at Oregon Ridge Park in Cockeysville, there's a basket making workshop with a master basket weaver, where you'll learn how to weave a wine bottle basket. There are some special materials you need to bring with you, so check out the website for more information. This Sunday in Annapolis is the First Sunday Arts Festival, which is always a great time. There's over 130 local and regional artists taking up the first few blocks of West Street. At the Anne Arundel County Public Libraries this week. On Monday at the Glen Burnie Library is Maker Mondays for Teens. And if you missed the Challenge Island Junior events last week at a couple libraries, they're coming up again this week at different libraries. At the Severna Park Library on Monday, and at the Deal Library on Tuesday. And as a reminder, Challenge Island is where preschoolers and elementary school students explore science and engineering through music. Children work in teams to combine creativity and critical thinking to design musical instruments which will be used in a musical performance at the end of the class. This Saturday at Unallocated Space in Severn, from 2 to 6 p.m. is Crafternoon, Cosplay 101, Intro to Cosplay. And if you're not sure what cosplay is, it's basically costumes. Whether it's for an upcoming convention, where you want to dress up as your favorite superhero or comic book character, or even just for Halloween, which seems like it's kind of far away. But if you don't start working on your costume now, you know you'll never get it finished. So show up at Unallocated Space on Saturday and get some ideas. Get started on that killer costume for this year. Tonight at Annapolis Makerspace is Basics of Electronics with Tom. And as always, you can catch me tonight and every Thursday night at Annapolis Makerspace on Renard Court for Electronics Night. And I'll be posting links to these events on the Annapolis Makerspace website at makeannapolis.org sometime today. And whether you're making art, software, sawdust, or costumes, chances are you're already a maker. This has been Trevor from Annapolis Makerspace with this week's Maker Minutes.
Thanks for listening to the Eye on Annapolis Daily News Brief. If you like what you heard, make sure to tell your friends and colleagues about it. And also tell them about our website, ionannapolis.net, where you can find much more. Be sure to check out our other weekly podcast, The Maryland Crabs. This podcast comes to you every Monday through Friday at 7 a.m. Thanks for listening, and we'll see you next time.